non-market housing, which is the business that BC Housing is in with a multiple of different formats as you've outlined, but it's all about the idea that you're not putting it on the MLS listings and it's not really a private sector real estate determined price. That whole approach of using non-market housing as we see it in a place like Victoria, where we're getting so far away from the average income buying, able to buy the average house. So I know that that's the future of in many international cities. Do you agree? Do you see that as the future in BC, that we're going to have a permanent requirement for non-market help with housing in order to meet our workforce needs?
Well, I think we're probably inching closer to that. But what about the path of working in partnership with the private sector, community housing sector, local government to increase vacancy rates, create more healthy rental markets that you can actually deliver for an affordable price for folks? And I would argue now that we're in the at or near market housing business now. Our projects with some of the developers in this room are precisely that. Those they're targeting, you know, household incomes between $60,000 and $80,000, and that seems to be that missing middle or workforce housing.
Yeah. So you think we can go a long distance with that approach before we have to say it's all going to be about rentals that are funded and subsidized?
Yeah. Okay. Only because government's not going to be able to subsidize and fund them all.
Right. Right. And.